Well, I mean, let's talk about it. Well, first off, let's talk about, you know, Drake. Is he a real rapper? Is he hip hop or is he pop? Because, you know, Mos Def said that his music is for Target, it's for shopping, it's commercial, pop music. Bryson, you
did
listen Drake
to what Mos said? Did you hear what Mos said? Did you listen to the interview?
Yeah, I watched the clip. Is there a full interview out?
Because, well, so this is the thing, man. I read what he said. I saw it on a website. I think probably like Hot New Hip Hop, one of them hip hop gossip sites.
Mm-hmm.
And so I read it. I was like, dang, this sounds like a diss. But when you watch the clip, it's not like I thought it was jokes. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I think some people take it, you know, taking it different ways than to me what's intended. But go ahead, B. How did you feel when you saw this clip of your hero getting roasted?
Man, I don't watch no damn clip that say Mos Def. I read the headline, saw that it said that he was more pop. I started to watch like 5 seconds of the clip. It's like, I really don't give a fuck. I mean, sure, Drake is pop. I don't think he cares about it. I think that's his intent, is to be pop. I don't think he's trying to be real hip-hop.
Well, he responded, wait, hold on. I don't think that's true at all. I think Drake wants hip-hop respect from hip-hop. Yeah, that's not true at all. He posted on Instagram, too. He posted an interview of Method Man saying that, you know, hip-hop is, you know, it's more than just the music. It's the culture. It's the way he speaks, the way he talks, the way he dresses, all that stuff. You know, and so, you know, he was saying, I'm hip-hop regardless of what people think. So Drake definitely has always wanted the respect of hip-hop. Always. Always,
yeah,
always,
I didn't
always
say that he doesn't want the respect. Yes, 100%. I agree with that.
So, I mean, yeah, I just think that that's wrong to say that he doesn't care.
Well, he cares a ton, man. You know this dude cares.
The decision to be a big artist, you are giving up your right to be categorized in one thing, I feel like. There, you have to be bigger than the genre. Or otherwise, you can't break out. I don't think there's any way to... How can you break through the glass ceiling if you don't transition? I don't get that.
I guess that's my problem, though. That's my... Okay, so I think that's... Okay, I think that's kind of the problem. When people say Drake is pop, it's because of what you're saying. This need to break out past the genre or something like that. Like, mm-hmm. You know, if you love hip hop, man, I mean, it's Drake has made plenty of hit rap songs, okay? Mm-hmm. And lots of rap artists have made plenty of money doing it. But when we consistently want to reach outside of the core hip hop fan base to get other people, you know, to get placed in a Target or to get to be, you know, make the kind of music that is you want to get played in the mall or whatever, or like that sort of thing, the very commercial stuff that you want to play for, you know, young white girls or something like that. I mean, I think that's some people have a problem with that. Like, just you could just keep making music for your community.
It's trash, but that is Drake community. I don't know why people act like it's not. Young white girls is Drake community. I mean, like, come on, man. This is the type of stuff that this dude makes his music for a reason. Mm-hmm. So he made a choice. That's what he wants to make. So I don't know why he would get so offended. That's my thing. Like, I saw a lot of people, like Drake fans, like rushing to his defense as if he A, needs defending. And B, what does it matter? Like, who even, like, do y'all, I'm surprised people even care what Mos says. I mean, Mos ain't been really out here like that. When's the last rap? I mean, he has the Black Star album, but is he putting out solo work? Is he out here, you know, really in the media spaces? Cause I haven't really seen him like that. Outside of the stuff he'd been doing with like him and Kweli and Chappelle and stuff like that. I didn't know people really cared. I didn't think young rap fans cared at all. I didn't think a Drake fan would ever care what Mos Def said.
Man, I think, well, one, I think, one, two, there's two things. First off, I think we underestimate exactly who Drake's fan base is, because I think it's a lot of people, a lot of ages that are Drake's fan base, not just young white girls. I think that's part of the thing. There's a lot of older people who still like Drake and whatever, all this stuff, right? But secondly, I think we also underestimate how big Mos Def is to the culture. I feel like he's an icon in the culture. When he says something to me or does something, it seems like I see it, you know? Like, I see it on social media and stuff, you know?
Okay. I mean, he's credible. He's definitely, I would say, he's close to legend status. I don't know if he got it locked down, but he definitely has stuff that would make people say that. So, all right.
I don't, if you're not like a legend, said, man, I don't know who is, man. I definitely think he's a legend.
Ooh, I don't know if I agree with that.
Yeah, now we're gonna argue where if Mos is a legend and at what point, like what extent, what level of legend? A legend?
Yeah,
is he a top 25 rapper all the time?
Okay, maybe not 25. Okay. I don't.
Is he top 50?
I think he could be top 50.
I think he could be top 50 as well. I think he could be. I had to go through and make a list now, but
then there's 49 legends if he 50.
I think that's fair to say that there's 50 legends. I feel like that's fair. In this culture at this time, there's 50 years of hip hop music. I think 50 legends isn't that crazy to say.
Yeah, for sure. He's not a legend. I can't.
All right, see, this is good. This is good. This is good because this is part of, you know, because we also want to talk about Black on Both Sides, and I want to talk about Mos Def legacy in hip-hop as well, because I think this is the same, you know, reaction some people had. Like, who is Mos Def to be talking on Drake? You know, how can he criticize Drake or whatever, stuff like that? So I think, and man, it's interesting. I'm shocked that y'all would say he's not a legend. To me, he has made music that is, you know, he's made classic music. He is known as a legendary lyricist. He's rapped with, you know, many people. The issue is he hasn't produced a lot of music, right? So in the same way,
He has like 6 albums though, right?
He's got like 4 albums though.
I mean,
well, if you count his group albums.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So he's got 6 albums, yeah.
I mean, that's not a small amount. It's not consistent output for, it's not Nas or somebody like that has put out tons of albums, but I mean, when he come out, 97, 98? When did Sound Bombing come out? Raucous. Right? And the Raucous stuff was... Look, I was in high school when this came out, man. I remember that Raucous being, like, the realest stuff out. Like, I remember being like, yo, this is where I'm at. And this type of stuff I wanted to hear. So, I had a big affinity for Mos. I just don't know if I put him in a legendary status because he chose to not really put out as much music. I mean, Dude Drop, I think he have a couple classics under his belt, though. And we'll talk about the quality of those albums. When we get into talking about his legacy, but I definitely think he's credible. I think that's what it is that hip hop fans think he's credible. When he says something is hip hop, people say Mos said this. That's credible. He's a credible voice in hip hop. I do think that. We can debate the legendary stuff.
Yeah, I just don't think he's a legend. He is credible for sure.
Yeah,
legend. Baby Bree in the chat says that a friend knows the name but don't know the music. I don't know if that's the case for most people. I don't feel like most people know who Mos Def is.
Man, come on, dude. He's got so many legendary moments in hip-hop. Like, whether it's, even if it's, you're talking about the Good Friday stuff with Kanye, he's got, you know, big moments on there. Whether you talk about, you know, Black Star itself was a moment, that Raucous movement was a moment, Black on Both Sides. You know, it's he's got the freestyle on Dave Chappelle. Close Edge performance on Dave Chappelle is a legendary moment. I mean, he's got several.
That sounds like a bunch of reaching to me, dog. I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm not rolling.
He's got several songs.
This dude just did a whole round of yoga, man. Whole bunch of.
Hey, all right, okay, yeah, all right.
Hey, no way. No, I'm
nah,
sorry.
Nah. Look, I don't understand. I was there. I feel like I was there when Mos was coming out and when these albums was released. Like you was like 10, so like that's I was that. Hyped. So to me, I definitely feel as I feel like he is as well. I just don't know if I could just say that objectively about all of hip hop, because I don't know if that's the case. To me, Black Star and Black on Both Sides were, you know, like formative. Like this is I listened to as a, like I said, high school years. So you know that I have great affinity for the music. Mm-hmm. I just don't know if I'm just sitting around like, oh, Mos Def. If he drops an album, I'm running to hear it. So we, like I said, saying legend is like whatever, man. We can talk about that. We can debate that. But you know, we can get back to the whole thing with the Drake stuff. Is I just thought this was kind of real silly, because he was making jokes about, you know, Drake. They asked him, is he hip hop? And he said Drake is pop. So he kind of like took it a different direction. He didn't say no, you know, because Drake makes hip hop music, man. Drake is a hip hop fan turned hip hop creator. And so, yeah, I mean, we're not going to sit up here and say he's not a hip-hop artist. Like, he is.
Of course.
You know, as far as some of the other stuff, like the stuff about all... But everything he said about Drake's music being very palatable in that type of way where you could be in the mall and that type of stuff that's playing, you wouldn't think twice. It definitely is true. That's all legitimate.
Yeah.
And those are jokes. You know, he was saying, like... And I think that's why, obviously, Drake felt it. Because he felt like he had to respond in some kind of way, or thought it was time for joke responses or whatever. But it clearly hit.
Yeah, no, I agree. I think he was joking. It to me, he had a, you know, it was a funny, you know, funny response. I don't get why, like, I like artists saying their opinions and being themselves and showing personality in an interview. And I think it's, you know, I think it's important. You know, sometimes you see artists, and because they're so afraid of saying anything, they just won't say, like, you know, like the everything is very, like, you know, cut and paste response. You know, it's all the same responses.
Yeah, degree responses.
And that's boring. Like, that's boring. You ask, like, you know, so I thought this was funny. But my thing is, my question is, what makes someone pop? Because we know he makes hip-hop music. Of course, he's a rapper. He's rap. He's got tons of hip-hop music. We know that. What makes someone pop? What is pop music? And what makes someone pop?
That's a good question. I mean, you can step into the pop lane because there's a lot of rappers who made song with the hot white chick at the time who's making the best pop songs, whatever. Like Katy Perry got a bunch of rap features when she was hot. Taylor Swift got a rap feature, I'm sure. I mean, I'm not sure.
Let me get some. Who are some of these Katy Perry rap features? This is going to be dope. I kind of want to look these up. She got a song with 2 Chainz, you said?
Yeah. That's about the only one that I know off the top of my head.
I don't know, though. Katy Perry and 2 Chainz is funny, Doug. What's that song called, man? I'm going to look that shit up.
Damn, I might be wrong. You put me on the spot. I'm going to be real upset if I'm wrong. But I feel like they got one.
Nah, that's a good look for Chainz. I ain't mad. I'm just laughing. Like, that's funny. I want to know what that sounds like, man. But, I don't know what's, what makes it pop. Pop, what pop means is it's consumable in the mass audience. So, whatever it is that makes, people's parents, maybe when you were younger, recoil from the music, say, oh, you got to turn that off. That's bad. That's not good. We don't listen to that. That's not that Drake don't have that in his music. It's not that. So the edge is dulled. I don't know how you just how you can feel it. You could hear it when you listen to it. I mean, obviously, there's a certain type of production, too. I mean, you can't be rapping over no conductor beats and then. This is like that's probably not the move. You know, my man Derringer he's probably not gonna get a bunch of Drake pop hits.
But I mean, Drake just rapped over the Conductor beat.
And we talked about that when it happened, and we talked about why. Is Drake wants, and look, I'm not going, I don't know for sure, but seeing my dude wants approval and love from the rappity rap lovers like people like myself and others. And maybe he's not trying to be our friend, but he definitely would like it if MCs like Mos Def gave him respect.
Mm-hmm.
And talked about him like he was a legend, like he was a Jigga, like he was a Nas, like he was this type of dude that people respect. And he's not. And I don't think he'll ever be that. I don't know. I don't know how that works for y'all. What do you think, B-Dog? Is that something that Drake can obtain?
Yeah, for sure. I don't know. Actually, I feel like a lot of OGs have come out and spoke on accepting Drake more and more. But I don't know, man. I just feel once you go to the top, you're not the, I don't know. Once you make it there, I think things are different for you.
Yeah, I mean,
I think Jay-Z reached the top. So, you know, people don't speak on him this way.
As big as Jay-Z was, he was never as big as Drake. Not in terms of sales or streams, as big, widespread in throughout, I said, Jay-Z, I don't think he was ever the type of music that, like we said, the teenage white girls were going to be the predominant, you know, their predominant favorite, you know, artists. I don't think that's the case. Was it?
I mean, when he was rapping on any beats, there was a pretty big deal.
That's isn't he in your song.
Favorite song? Don't they shout him out on your favorite song ever? Party in the USA. Don't they talk about the Jigga song was on? You know you love that song, man. That's your song, boy. Every time that song comes,
yeah.
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 Yeah. And she put her hands up. Yeah,
Party in the USA.
Yeah, that's it. You're okay. Right. Yeah. Okay, you might be. Yeah,
you got a Justin Timberlake song and that Umbrella song with Rihanna. Like, those are all pop songs.
Being featured on another, someone else's track, like Crazy in Love is a huge song. Like, that's what I'm saying. Jay-Z has songs like that where he's featured on a pop artist's record. That's different, though. Yeah. That's a rap feature on a pop song. It's not. Quite the same as what Drake does, which will have when he has his own hits on his own albums that are huge pop singles. I think that's just I just think it's slightly different. I don't know exactly what the numbers are. I have to look it up, but I don't think that Drake has set records for number one hits and being on the charts, you know, as most hits and stuff like that. Time Michael Jackson or whatever he tied, right? That's a different level. Michael Jackson, I mean, and Jay-Z are not the same level. Like, that's what I'm saying.
Hold on. First of all, that Michael Jackson stuff is nonsense, man. We talking about streaming compared to when people went and bought albums. Like, it's not even close to the same thing. But I do think, yes, but hip-hop itself is bigger. The times are bigger. The times have changed. So I think Jay-Z had big hits. What's his last big hit? That song was probably that one.
Wait, what?
Was that probably Jay-Z's last big hit with Alicia Keys?
New York. Oh, yeah. Okay.
I'm just trying to think. Is that might be his one of his last big hits? And I'm sure that one got big numbers. I mean, they play that still a bunch. I'm like, oh god, yeah, not this again.
I hate that song.
I can't stand it.
But yeah, that's a huge hit.
But they play that a lot. So
yeah.
I don't know if that's, you know, it's the same time. That was, 10, 15 years ago now at this point. And, you know, so I think that Drake has continued to be on top as hip-hop has continued to be the dominant form for some time. And he is at the top record sales-wise for sure. So I do think that's a thing. My question is just, like, why does he... Either he's never going to get the respect of that type of MC. I feel like he does want that.
All right, so this is my
opinion. And when people talk about him, they respect him for his sales and money. He getting money.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. 100%. He's getting money. It's not the same respect. Exactly. It's not the same respect as it being is. Respected as a rapper. No, it's not the same respect. Now,
what other rapper catches all these strays from people?
Because here's the thing about Jay-Z. Here's the thing about Jay-Z. Jay-Z gets respect from a business standpoint. People know he's bought his business. He made the money. He gets respect that way. He gets respect from, you know, lyricists as well. He gets respect from all circles. Now, not everyone might say he's the GOAT, but he gets respect from all circles. No one is saying Jay-Z's lame. People say that about Drake. People say Drake is whack or Drake is lame. It's just not the same level of respect. It's not the same thing.
Let me be the first to say it. Jay-Z is lame. If y'all didn't know, this nigga is lame.
Okay, now you crazy. Now you crazy. See, that's unreasonable. That's just being unreasonable.
Jay-Z raised a lot of niggas.
I mean, look, this is the place for that, man. Get your hate off, dog.
All right. This nigga Jay-Z raised a lot of niggas, so now they love this nigga. I can't stand this dude, man. He gets so much love. When we go back over the album,
see, this is jealousy speaking. This is your jealousy speaking. That don't make no sense. You mad that he's loved? That don't make no sense.
I'm not mad that he's loved. But they
no, you mad like that he's more loved more than Drake?
I don't know how to compare that. But I'm mad that this nigga get. They act like Jay-Z can't do no wrong. That's what I'm mad at.
I don't think people say that.
I mean, I agree. I think his stands are just as annoying as anyone else's stands. Maybe more so. But, more so. You know, stands are stands.
Stands are stands. The Jay-Z stands are not more annoying than the Kendrick stands. No, Kendrick stands are worse.
Oh,
Kendrick stands are worse. Because even a Jay-Z stand won't say that he has all classic albums. A Kendrick stand will swear up and down that the dude has six classic albums, never made a bad song.
But you know what? Drake stands is annoying too, bro. They'll sit up here and tell you that electronic album is fire.
That shit is fire. Look, here you go. Right on time. Here you go. About to put on the tape. JC, here we go. These, dog, it's nasty. First of all, the same way that people was clowning Academics at first when he came out and was loving all on Drake and this, Drake that. That's the same way a lot of these grown adults are about Jay-Z. It's nasty behavior.
Oh, yeah.
I hate hearing people talk about Jay-Z. It's disgusting to listen.
Yo, Hov did this, man. Yo, Hov said that. Yo, Hov said that. Oh, yo, I'm trying to be like Hov. Yeah, that is annoying. I get it. It's just nasty. Annoying in other stands, man.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Okay, and I do think that Jay-Z stands, especially in the past, are really bad. But now, currently, today, are not the worst fan base because Jay-Z has stopped making music for the large part.
Secondly, tone down.
Even the Jay-Z stands, like when he dropped his newest record, even the Jay-Z stands did
they
like
had
that.
To admit that's trash. They had to, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So,
Jay-Z trying to get his Keisha Plum on, man. Who the hell you think he is, man? What's up with that, man? You're not Keisha Plum. You know what I'm saying? Next time they want the spoken word, they need to get the spoken word artist, the master. You know what I'm saying? Keisha Plum.
Word. Yeah, no, whatever he did was not it. And like I said, even the Jay-Z stands know that. So I don't want to get caught into...
That's what we do. We got to get off topic.
Yeah.
Oh, snap. I didn't realize. Oh, Leroy in there. Okay. I didn't realize this stuff was blowing more people in the chat. But, so when you look at this whole thing with the Drake stuff, he's the only one who catches this type of disrespect for a top rapper, man.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. There's no other rappers since he's been out that have reached even close to his level. So we wouldn't know. There's nothing to compare him to. He doesn't have peers besides Kendrick, but like you said, everyone thinks Kendrick is Jay-Z. Jay-Z and Kendrick are like the same to me as far as
Eminem got stands like crazy, man. And they swear that everything this dude dropped is great as well. That Eminem stands is sitting up there talking about boing, boing, boing. Like, that's just hard. Oh, Paul.
That's true. Eminem. Eminem does have terrible stands, too. I agree. That is a good example. But All right, so here's a we got off track. I want to go back to my original question was, what is pop? To me, I want to give my definition. To me, pop music is, I feel like when someone's a pop artist is when they are constantly reaching to make whatever's the popular kind of music, okay? So, and what I mean by that, with Drake, just take his last album, for example. He gets on a track with Yeet and does the Yeet-type track because Yeet's hot. You know, and he'll do whatever is hot to stay on top, right? So he'll make whatever kind of music, do whatever kind of thing, completely change his sound, change his whole style of music to stay hot. And that's to me what like pop commercial is about. It's not about the art, it's about whatever's gonna be number one. It's whatever's gonna sell to the audience. And that's, I think, part of, I think that's sort of anti-hip-hop, because you know, hip-hop is in you know, in its core, its essence, it's kind of you know, rebellious, and to just make whatever's popular for the sake of popularity is goes against the spirit of hip-hop in a way. And I think that's why a lot of these hip-hop artists don't respect Drake in that way, because he's just following trends, and hip hop is supposed to be about setting your own trends. Or, you know what I mean? In a way. If that makes sense. That's to me, that's how I see it. If you jumping on other people's style, or you biting, you jocking, whatever's hot, I don't think that's cool.
I personally like it. I think it is cool. I like when he gives, like, the Migos, when they first came out, he jumped on their track super early, blew them up. I think that's cool. Bringing up the next young artist and blowing them up, giving them a look. Because I know if I was an artist, I would want that look. I'd be like, oh, you got the best person in the games to come on your song? That's fire to me. And I feel like a lot of people strive to achieve that. So I think that's cool. I think more people should get on other people's songs. That's why I like that J. Cole's doing all these features now. Seems very accessible. If you need a feature from J. Cole, just seem like all you got to do is ask him. He's going to be on your song, even though you don't expect it. Last year, he did that London song with Bia. That was weird. Never would expect that from J. Cole, or 2 years ago. I think that's cool.
But, so, okay, I think more. But you're proving my point, because to me, they're very different how they do their features. J. Cole will get on somebody's track and just do J. Cole, which is he's gonna bar up the track, and that's cool. Drake will get on the track, and if he's with a singer, he'll try to sing with them, or he'll do whatever kind of thing they do. He'll get with, you know, he got with the trap artist and do the trap music. He'll get with this artist and do this type of music. He'll, you know, whatever thing it is that's hot, he'll get with Yeet and try to do the Yeet music. It's not the same. J. Cole's not, you don't hear him trying to be anybody else but him. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, Drake done about half the genres except for country and jazz, probably. But he got a flute album coming, I heard, after that Andre one was successful. I heard he got a couple flute songs, and I also heard in his next album, he gonna be doing country line dance songs.
They said he got a country album coming.
Would I be surprised? Be to get off the Drake from Canada right to the country.
That's they gonna call it. Time to get off the Drake train right there.
You gonna have Nelly on the track with him, and they gonna do country together?
No, I think it was Morgan Wallen, I think, in his video. I don't know
who that is. I don't know who that is.
Just assuming. I think that was his name, but yeah, they say Drake about to do a country album. That would be funny, but
no one would be surprised.
I won't be listening to that one.
Yeah, that's terrible. All right, let's move on, man. So.